The Premier has ordered a report into the release of a mentally ill sex killer from a prison psychiatric facility.
Barry O'Farrell wants to know why it took police 3 days to inform the public Trent Jennings was on the run. It's believed he's already attacked another victim.
Well, Jess Pelliccioni joins us now from the Sydney Police Centre. Jess, where do police think he is right now?
Hamish, they believe he's somewhere on the eastern seaboard, but they need the public's help tracking him down. Police believe that there is the potential for Jennings to be dangerous. However, they haven't issued a major issue warning to the public for their own safety due to the fact that he carefully targets his alleged victims online. But 10 News has spoken exclusively to his former housemate today, who says he's very concerned Jennings could strike again.
Trent Jennings is on the run 8 years after tying up and killing a man in a Ngawi park. This man, who is too scared to be identified, was living with Jennings at the time.
Knowing he was locked up was the one comfort I had, and it just essentially opened the doors.
Jennings murdered Giuseppe Vitale after meeting him on a gay website. In 2005, he was found not guilty of murder due to mental illness. In November, the 26-year-old was granted day release from Morisset Psychiatric Hospital. On the 29th of December, Jennings allegedly struck again, assaulting a Zetland man, tying him up and stealing his car before returning to hospital in Morisset. The next day, he was stopped by police, allegedly heading north in the stolen Mercedes-Benz.
He was issued some infringement notices and let go.
This is the silliest thing I've ever heard. He's miles away from where he should be. Surely someone would have contacted the police, or the police would have something on their system that says he shouldn't be here.
About an hour later, the Zetland man reported the attack to police, who were defending their failure to tell the public Jennings was at large until today.
We believed at the time we could lay our hands on Mr. Jennings without too much trouble. However, clearly that has not been the case.
But the Premier isn't convinced. He's ordered a review into what went wrong.
I share some of the concerns about the lack of information about his release or his escape. I certainly share community concerns about the alleged incident he's been involved in, and I'll get a report of that.
Police are warning internet users to be cautious when meeting people online.
Particularly to invite strangers who they have no idea who they are into their homes.
Jennings could still be travelling in a Mercedes similar to this one, with number plates ALM, H2B. His former flatmate has this plea.
Get the help you need before you hurt somebody else.
Jess Pelliccioni, 10 News.